We live our lives day in and day out, going to work or school, eating dinner, doing sports, or just chilling at home. Through all of this, we assume we are the ones in the driver's seat. But what if there are secret agents who actually control our every decision? Today, we'll uncover the signs of the five oldest of these agents we call emotions. Hey folks, Philip here. Let's dive right into emotions and feelings. Researchers in the last century have discovered several core or basic emotions. Scientists from San Francisco have been studying facial expressions in many, many cultures around the world and discovered that there are about 5 to 6 core emotions that are identical, also in facial expression, among all humans on Earth. I want to talk about 5 of those today. Fear, anger, disgust, sadness, and happiness. Let's go. All right, so what are emotions and what are they good for? Let's start with fear. Fear makes a lot of sense as a basic core emotion. It helps you avoid potentially dangerous things in the world around you. In its simplest form, it's the hell no, I'm out of here emotion. It's defined by avoidance behavior. It's goal directed. You're trying to get away from something or someone. Imagine being born without any fear and endless curiosity. You would be petting grizzlies and tigers and be eating any plants you can see. You wouldn't be around for much longer.
When you're smiling, when you're smiling.
Oh, shit! I said over easy!
One of the best predictors of anger is pain, and that reveals something about its usefulness and utility. It helps you to release energy, that's its main purpose. Anger, with its accompanied change in heart rate and muscle tone, prepares you to fight or flight.
Jackson loves broccoli. Here, baby, you hold it.
Try it again. Disgust can be explained fairly easily. It's an evolutionary mechanism to protect us from eating poisonous food or getting too close to contaminated things, kind of like broccoli. The purpose of sadness isn't quite so clear. Even though it shares the negative valence or unpleasantness of other emotions like fear and disgust, it's distinct from them. And it's hard to define or explain it because everybody intuitively knows what sadness feels like. But what's its purpose? Well, that's not as easy to figure out. Happiness, ironically, is the odd one of the 5 emotions. What's its evolutionary purpose? To find a narrative that makes sense of why we need happiness, of why it evolved, is not so easy. Perhaps happiness is just a lack or absence of all negative emotions. We are inherently more fearful of spiders and snakes and heights than guns or cars. Our brains have been shaped by evolution to avoid the things our ancestors encountered on a daily basis and that were dangerous to them. But it's even more complicated than that, because if you have to speak in front of a large audience or a big group or on YouTube, that can also create fear, because it puts you inherently in a scary position within your tribe. We get angry from being hurt physically or emotionally, but also from watching our favorite football team lose again and again and again. People we've never met get paid millions and millions and can't even kick a ball into a net even once. Disgust for modern brains can apply to more than just rotten food. It can also apply to other people and their behavior, especially if those other people are different or part of an outgroup, a nebulous group of others that doesn't belong to us. Our evolutionary mechanism for sadness has expanded to such a degree that it now applies not only to ourselves, but to other people we've never met or even other species. In that sense, our capacity for empathy and compassion is unparalleled by any other animal. I can get happy from a good plate of food, a promotion at work, or good grades at school. But I can also get happy by sitting alone in my room playing a game with other people around the world I have never met before. All of those instances are clear instances of happiness. Let's talk about the brain and emotions. Where in the brain are emotions located and what happens there exactly? Anger seems to be located in the frontal part of your brain called the orbital frontal cortex, and orbital obviously meaning the eyeballs, around the eyeballs, everybody knows this. Disgust has been shown time and time again to be activating a part of the brain called the insula, the island on both hemispheres of your brain. And that part of your brain not only activates with rotten food and feces and vomit, but also with morally outrageous acts of other people. Fear continuously activates the amygdala, and the amygdala is really important for fear responses. When you see like a snake, for instance, the amygdala goes crazy immediately. Sadness is a bit more difficult, but we think sadness activates the anterior cingulate cortex, which is an important region in between the modern, more modern neocortex of your brain and the more classically older part, the limbic system. Happiness is funny. We don't actually know where happiness is in the brain. There is no region we know of that consistently activates with happiness. That's weird, right? One of the most prominent emotions, and we can locate it in the brain. I don't know. Sometimes science is complicated, and not every brain scan tells you what's going on in some reason. It's the worst when scientists pretend to understand everything. Why the f*** don't we know where happiness is in the brain? Everything you told them about emotions is wrong. Wait, what? I was calling out to me. Hey everyone, thanks for watching. That was such a fun but difficult video to make. Second episode about emotions, which you can find here on the left, it will release it in the beginning of December, will explain a new theory about emotions. In the meantime, if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe as well. Thank you so much for your support. It's truly appreciated. Think about its utility and function. Anger. Next up, anger. One of the best predictors of anger is pain. Shut the f*** up.